Students, this is the third part of the video on the normalization series. Okay, so in this video we are going to study what are known as Armstrong's axioms in DBMS and the inference rules of functional dependency. We have already studied functional dependency in the previous video, so in case you have not seen that video, you need to watch that video before you watch this. Okay, so please watch that video. So let's look at the inference rules for the functional dependencies. Given a set of functional dependencies F, we can infer additional functional dependencies that hold whenever the functional dependencies in F hold. The following are the Armstrong's inference rules. The first one is the reflexive rule. So it states that if Y is a subset of X, then X determines Y. Okay, similarly, using this inference rule of reflexive, we can also say that if X is a subset of X, then X determines X, right? Always X is a subset of itself. Similarly, the second inference rule is augmentation. If X determines Y, then we can say that XZ determines YZ. Okay. We can, while saying, we can say XZ stands for X union Z. So if I say this rule again, if X determines Y, then X union Z determines Y union Z. The third rule is transitive. So it states that if X determines Y and Y determines Z, then X determines Z. Okay. So this Y can be replaced with this Z. So basically, using these three inference rules, we can form other rules. Okay. So some additional inference rules that are useful are the decomposition rule. If X determines YZ, then we can say X determines Y and X determines Z. Then we have the union rule. So it states if X determines Y and X determines Z, then X determines YZ. So YZ, like I told you previously, you can pronounce it Y union Z. Then we have the pseudo transitivity rule. So it says if X determines Y and WY determines Z, then WX determines Z. So basically what happens is, since we are claiming that X determines Y, okay, since Y is determined by X, this Y here can be replaced by X. Okay, since Y is already being determined by X, this Y here on the left hand side can be replaced by X. Then we have the composition inference rule. If X determines Y and A determines B, then we can say that XA determines YB. Okay. So similarly, we can form more inference rules. We can deduce more rules from the first three rules that were given. Okay. So let's look at some definitions. The closure of a set F of FDs is a set F plus, where plus is the symbol for closure, of all FDs. Okay, FDs means functional dependencies that can be inferred from F. Closure of a set of attributes X with respect to F is the set X plus, which is the closure set of X, of all attributes that are functionally determined by X. The closure set X can be calculated by repeatedly applying the inference rules 1, 2, and 3 using the functional dependencies in F. So students, you need to study these inference rules and note down these inference rules properly, okay, in order to do normalization. Please study these inference rules properly, okay. At least these inference rules, the first three inference rules, you must know by heart, okay. You should be able to understand whenever I say reflexive rule, what is the meaning of reflexive, what is transitive, what is augmentation, what is decomposition, union, okay. So please study these rules properly. Thank you for listening.